Welcome back to the video. This is the 11th and the last video of the game development tutorials. So as you can see that in the last video we had created a winning screen which displayed click to continue, but there's nowhere over here to click and restart the game. So in this video we'll be creating an event listener to handle that event. So above the earlier created event listener, let's type canvas dot add event listener, and the event will be mouse down, which will be handled by the function handle mouse click. As you can see that I'm going to create this function outside this statement, not in the inline form as we did earlier over here. So now let's create the function handle mouse click. Before starting the window.onload function, we'll create that function handle mouse click. We'll pass an argument which is evt, and what this function will basically do is if we are showing the win screen at that time, what we want is we need to reset the scores of our player. So player 1 score equals 0 and player 2 score also equals 0. After that we'll again make that variable to the value false so that the player can restart the game. Now just focus on these two statements, which is initializing the player's score to 0. Over here also, where we compared the player's score with the winning score, we did the same thing, we reset our player's score to 0. So over here these two statements have no meaning, because what will happen over here is before deciding that left player has won or right player has won, the scores will be reset to 0. So we don't want this thing to happen over here, so we'll cut the statements from here. Let's save and refresh. So now after the game is over, the winning screen is being displayed. At the winning screen, we will be able to click and restart our game. Okay, so now it's showing click to continue. Let's click and it restarts the game. So now, so for displaying which player has won the game, we will need the same condition. So let's copy it, paste it inside the draw everything function where we are checking the variables boolean value. After creating the color, we'll paste that statement and we'll discard the OR operator, because we want these generic statements but individually. We don't want that both the statements are being performed at the same time and either of the statement is chosen. We want it to execute individually, so we'll create two statements from them. First will be if and the second will be else if. So if player 1 is winning, we need to display the player 1 as won statement. So for that, just copy the fill text line and paste it inside the if statement. Change the click to continue text to player 1 has won, or you can type left player has won. And for the next one, what we can do is if the player 2 score is greater than or equal to the winning score, we'll display right player has won or player 2 has won. And close the braces. Okay. So now it's time for the dimensions. So 100 by 100 is basically a very left side. So what we can do is we can make this 400 or maybe 350. 350 will be more accurate. And it will be 200 from the top And over here also we can give the same dimensions, because only one condition will be executed at a time. Both the conditions can't execute at the same time. If the first condition passes the test and satisfies the condition, it will be executed, else the second statement will be. So these two dimensions can be same. And the click to continue text, we need it to be below the left player one or right player one statement. So we'll give a dimension of 350 from left, and let's make it 5x6 from top, so 500. Let's save and refresh. Okay, so now you can see the text right player one has been displayed, and below over here click to continue is displayed. As we click, the game is restarted with the scores 0. So now what is remaining is to draw a net exactly at the center of the canvas. So for that we need to create one function. So we'll create one function named drawNet above the function drawEverything, so that all the drawing paths are at the same place. So we'll define one function over here, function drawNet. Name your functions as per what work they will be doing, so that's easy to understand. This function will be basically drawing a thin rectangle to represent a line. And if we want to draw a dotted line, we need to draw thin rectangles at some amount of space. So for that we need to create one for loop. A for loop basically has three segments. The first one is the initialization of the variable. The second is the maximum and the minimum amount of the variable. So our I will be always less than the canvas height. So canvas dot height. And the last segment is the increment and the decrement part. So over here our I will be increasing every time by 40. So we write I plus equals 40, which means I equals I plus 40. So inside the scope of the function, the scope of the for loop, what should happen is we need to draw thin rectangles. So we just need to copy this code of rectangle and paste it inside the for loop. Now to draw the net, firstly we need to divide the width by we need to divide the canvas width by 2, so that we are in the center. So we'll write canvas dot width by 2. Height, it will be starting from 0, so the initialized value, which is 0. The width of the rectangle will be very small, so 2, and height can be 15 to 20. Let's keep the color as white. So we will be drawing a white thin rectangle representing the dotted line at the intervals of 40. So white. And now just notice over here that we have divided the canvas into two parts vertically. Then from the center towards the right, these width goes towards the right. So towards the right 2 pixels we are drawing the rectangle. So it will be inside the right section, it won't be in the center. So what we need to do is we need to normalize this 2 in one part in the left side and the second part in the right side, so 1 and 1. So what we need to do is we need to subtract it by 1, so it will start 1 pixel behind the partition which we did. Okay, so let's save. Now your work is not done. As you create the function, you need to call the function somewhere. So inside the draw everything function, before drawing the paddles and the ball and after drawing the canvas, we need to draw the net, that is after the canvas. We'll call that function draw net. Let's save and refresh. Okay, so now you can see a beautiful net is drawn in the middle of the canvas. And here all the elements of our game has been completed, with the scores incrementing by 1, the right paddle doing its work very efficiently, though it is not that perfect, but it works fine.